Hey folks, Joey here with a video production show and tell for you guys. In the past, you might have seen that I really like small lights, small LED lights. I've talked about the Aperture M9, this little small LED light array. I've talked about the Quasar tube, something that can move around, act very portable and versatile. But I wanted to introduce you to this new light that I've been playing with for the last few days. This is the Relio². This is the second iteration of the Relio light cube. Now, you probably have seen us play with light cubes in the past on things like product or macro photography. And those are generally like factory made small plastic containers with inexpensive average LED light thrown in to flood out light. This is not that. This is a very, very high quality light, very handmade, well machined aluminum cube that packs a huge punch in a very high quality CRI, high CRI a light. Now this got my attention a few weeks ago when the Kickstarter launched for the Relio². I've seen the Relio one, I haven't had a chance to play with it, but I've always had my eye on it. And I got a chance to chat with the founder, Marco Bazzola. Now, Marco is a fellow maker and fellow tinkerer, and you can tell that by looking at this, just the packaging of this. You can tell that he's kind of meticulously pored over every detail on how this is set up, designed, the modularity of it, the versatility of it, just this beautiful laser cut box. You open it up and everything is laid out with accessibility in mind. Now I'll go over a bunch of stuff that's in these kits. What I have here is the Studio Plus and the Desk Plus. That's what was sent to me for review units. Now I've only had this for like a few days, so I've only really been playing with it. So I'm giving you a show and tell. I'll probably do like a full review or a demonstration on how we use these to modify the light and do product photography. That reveal will come in the future. This I just wanted to introduce you to, especially since the Kickstarter is ending this week, and if you have any interest, you can pop over there and kind of get some more detail on it. But let's go over what's inside this box. The first thing, as you open it, you'll notice the light cube. This is an all aluminum made small light cube with a variety of different color temperatures. I have mostly daylight, 5600. I do have one tungsten, I have a UV light that I've yet to play with. But since most of our studio stuff is 5600 daylight, that's what I opted for. Now, like I said, this stuff is high quality light. This is very high on the CRI index, which is the color rendering index, which we can dive down a whole nerdy color light science of charts later on. But for right now, just know that the high number means it's very good, a very good representation of what the sun or what pure light would be. That's important for a number of reasons, especially for this kit. This kit's not only for filmmakers and photographers, because for us, high quality light is very useful. We do want very nice looking light on the things that we photograph. But this also bleeds over into the scientific community, the research community, or even stuff like art restoration, where they need a very accurate representation. They can't have cheap light throwing off color casts on things when they're trying to reproduce something, or they need something that's just the pure daylight sun in studios or in situations where they won't have it. They need something very high quality, and that's what these are. A lot of the research, a lot of the R&D that went into these was to make sure that that light is super accurate so that it could, you know, benefit all these different parties. But for us, the filmmakers and photographers, it's just gonna look very nice, and it's gonna actually pack a huge punch for what these little lights are. So let's talk a little bit about the body. Like I said, it's all aluminum. It feels real sturdy. It's got these little vents here for cooling. You flip it over and you got your power connector there. It's all magnetic. On the bottom, you have your quarter inch screw to attach to whatever your quarter inch desires are. And then this is where it gets really fun, is with the modifiers and the front plate and the lenses. The modifiers are all 3D printed. So you have different ways you can manipulate this light. Right now, it's just kind of blowing out into a cone. There are a couple different variations of these lenses that you can attach on if you want different degrees, but everything is magnetic. So you essentially just pull off the front plate and you have access to your light here. Here you can change out your light if it burns out or goes bad, attach back on the front plate, and then your modifiers just sit on front as well. Again, magnetic. Everything just kind of clicks on, and it just has such a great, the power goes out to USB. You can attach any USB wall outlet, or you can do what I've been doing and been using one of these plates that the Relio makes It uses the Sony MPF batteries, which is very common. I'm using that to power a bunch of stuff in here. So I have a ton already. And then it gives you six USB outs so that you can essentially power one thing, power all your lights with one battery, which if you know anything about my rigging is that I love single source power solutions. I love to power as many things on one battery as possible. And this plate allows me to do that. There's the Relio app where you can access each of these lights individually and change the brightness and the dimming of them. There's a bunch of different kinds of stands. This is that desk unit where it comes with a nice sturdy base and a stand that you can screw through the quarter inch. There's a bunch of different rigging solutions. We can make different arrays. Again, I'm like 3 days into this, so I've yet to play with a lot of this stuff, but I did get to run a few different tests of just how I would use this in a shooting situation. So what I've done is I completely eliminated all light in my garage, my studio. I took out all the light and tried to emulate a few different styles. I set up some Gundam and did like a soft source area light. I did a bounce off of a white white panel that I shot in a spot, added some fill, and then I used a tungsten to give it a little bit of like a sunset highlight effect. Then I changed up the rig and I threw a duvetine cloth down and tried to emulate one of those like cocktail commercials, made a few different, had a few Waterford glasses, shining some light through them. Similar situation, some soft light, some bounce, again, all Relio, and then I used the tungsten light again to highlight that. And then I did your generic shop videos where you have your woodworker shaving off wood things with some warm light bouncing off of the warm walnut wooden slabs and end grain cutting boards. All fun stuff. And then, and I know this is not what this is supposed to be used for, but I lit up this entire situation with these lights only. I didn't use any of the normal lights I used. I set up an array of three with the soft boxes on them, shining through grid cloth to give me the key light here, all daylight. And then I just set up a reflector over here to give me a little bit of fill, just because I was kind of getting a little dark here. I have one just pretty bare, just one shining. Oh no, I do have a little diffusion on that, giving me a backlight or a hair light, and that's it. That's how much of a punch that these guys. I mean, three of them right here are blasting through a grid cloth, so two layers of diffusion, and it's still giving me a nice key source and allowing me to bounce. So that kind of gives you a sense of how the intensity of these lights are, and everything is set to daylight. The camera set the daylight, so I will see when I start to edit this video of how accurate that is, but just judging by the preview window, it looks pretty good. And again, being that these are high quality lights, you will not have any flickering in your high speed ranges for up to like a ton of frame rates. So I will have a lot more thoughts on these. Again, I'm still new to this whole system here, but I plan on doing some 3D printing of some of these modifications on them. I plan on trying up some different rigs and different emulates and different styles, and I'm looking forward to trying some macro photography. We will use this for product stuff. We do a lot of product shots, so we'll use that there. But as we start diving into those different operations with these, I will give you guys a full review video on this stuff. But that's the Relio² for now. If you're interested, go check out the Kickstarter, and Marco has a ton of information about the lights. And thank you guys for watching this video about lights. This is all very exciting stuff for me, and I'm looking forward to playing with it more. Hopefully it's exciting for you guys too. I will see you guys next time. Thank you. Talk then. Bye.